Finally, this week, after months of secrecy, Google has finally announced that its big Google Fiber project will be launching in Kansas City on July 26th. That's Thursday of next week. Google posted this short 30-second video on a new Google Fiber website thanking Kansas City and announcing the launch date. But other than the date, no detail was provided by Google about what specifically will be launched, what the availability will be, or pricing will be. Is this something to get excited about, or should Kansas City adopt a wait and see attitude?
I don't know. I'll have to Google that this afternoon to know the answer to that question. I'll do the best I can. I'm not sure we know exactly what the company will announce. I think there's great anticipation for what role Google and their fiber system, its fiber system, will play in our community. So we'll all have to wait and see.
Anticipate an announcement about services, what they're going to offer, and even perhaps what it might cost. And boy, Nick, this is one company that is just renowned for being secretive.
It's been like a two-year process, and we've really learned very little.
We've learned very little, but I think people still are excited about potential. We still don't know exactly how we're going to use this service. And what's amazing about this, everybody was so excited when the announcement came, and here we sit 2 years later, and people are scratching their heads saying, well, how are we going to use it? And we don't know yet.
Well, this was a national competition, and KCK and KCMO won out on this competition for sort of a very secretive prize. We still don't know what the prize is. We're still waiting to find out. But I think that no matter what it is, speed matters. If you have high-speed connectivity, the city feels like they can lure in more technology companies to take advantage of that. It will help elevate Kansas City's stature as a high-tech community.
The mayor put together a committee. Mike Burke was on it to study ways to exploit the Google Fiber system, and the committee came back with a report, and they sort of said, well, maybe this, maybe that,
right.
We're not sure.
Exactly.
We'll have to wait and see. So I'm not sure anyone completely understands what kind of impact it's going to have.
One of those recommendations was, let's even forget about Google and just say, let's have universal internet access in Kansas City, and let's make that one of our goals. So regardless of what Google does, let's do that, and that would be a noble goal by itself.
It would be, and there's also a group that wants to come to town, Code for America. It would use technology to make city government more responsive to people. They're very interested in coming because Google's here, Nick.
And that is our Week in Review. Our thanks to our news reviewers from the Kansas City Star, Dave Helling, and Steve Kraske. You can also hear him weekday mornings at 11 on KCUR-FM as the host of Up to Date, and the Star's City Hall reporter, Lynn Horsley. I'm Nick Haynes. From all of us here at KCPT, thanks for spending part of your weekend with us.